Hello everyone. So today we are going to discuss about your categories of paste. This particular video is the second part of the second video, that means part 2, section B. So without wasting time, let's start. So here you can see we are going to discuss about these categories of paste. Okay. So what is happening in this particular topic, there is some groups like categories of paste based on occurrence. This one you can see. Second one is categories of paste based on intensity of infestation. Third one is categories of paste based on damage potential. Okay, so like this, three categories are there, and in each category, two to three subgroups are there. So we have to understand each and everything. Now, if we start, here you can see based on occurrence that can be classified as regular paste, occasional paste, seasonal paste, persistent paste, sporadic paste. Some of these subcategories will come. So first one is what your regular paste. Regular in the sense frequently, yes or no? These are the paste which occur most frequently. That means regularly they will come, whatever may be the situation. If the crop you are growing, then definitely they will come to the crop, and they have a close association with that particular crop. Okay, like your chili thrips. Okay, then brinjal fruit and soot borer, or soot and fruit borer. Then your rice stem borer. Okay. You see, in this brinjal soot and fruit borer, sometimes it is written as soot and fruit, sometimes it is written as fruit and soot. What is the meaning? Both are same. Like, you see what some are thinking, that they will attack the soot first, then they will attack the fruit. That's why they are telling soot and fruit. But fruit and soot means the economic part is fruit. That's why they are writing fruit and soot. So it depends. Okay, but anyhow, the species is same. That is your Lucinodes urbonalis and your rice stem borer, Scirpophaga insectulus. Okay, and the chili thrips is Scirpophaga dorsalis. Okay, these are the regular pest, occurs most frequently, and they have a close association with that particular crop. That is known as what your regular pest. Now coming to your occasional pest, here what will happen, these are the pest which comes infrequently. That's why it is known as what your occasional. That means there is no time specific also. Any time of the year they may come. Okay, occurs infrequently, and here they have a close association with a particular crop. That is in case of what? Regular. But here what will happen? Here that close association won't be there with a particular crop. Close association with a particular crop is absent. Yes or no? Huh? There is no close association, and they occur infrequently. Okay, that is known as what? Your occasional pest. So if you think, for example, this rice caseworm, okay, Nymphola dipunctalis, here you can see, okay, these are the rice caseworm, okay, falling in the water, and they will attack the plants. Okay, rice caseworm, Nymphola dipunctalis. Then your Castor slug caterpillar, Parasalepida. Okay, this one is your Castor slug caterpillar. Then your mango stem borer. Okay, this one is the mango stem borer. You can see longhorn. Yes or no? Huh? This is what your mango stem borer, Betocera rufomaculata. Okay, these are what your occasional pest. They may not be observed in the field always. Occasionally, they may be observed in the field. Next one is your seasonal pest. That means time specific. In a particular season, in a particular time of the year, they will come. When the favorable situation will come, then only they will come. Yes or no? Okay. So you see, seasonal pest means what? Occurs mostly during a particular part of the year or in a particular season. Okay. In a specified crop, and usually the incidence is governed by the climatic condition. If the climatic situation, like rainfall, is favorable for a particular pest, then only this pest will emerge. If summer season is not favorable for a particular season, that means at that time they won't emerge. Yes or no? This is what your seasonal pest. So if you see, for the example, here you can see red hairy caterpillar on groundnut during June to July, rice grasshopper June to July, again mango huffers during flowering season only they will come. Okay, these are what your example of seasonal pest. Now coming to your persistent pest, as you can see, occur on a crop almost throughout the year. That means if the crop is there, this pest will be there completely in the field. Regular means regularly it will come and go. The persistent means what will happen throughout the year, they will be there. For example, thrips on chili. This is also a regular pest, this is also a persistent pest. But what is the difference if someone will ask? In regular pest, what will happen? They may lie near to your ETL level. But in case of persistent, just they are maybe near the damage boundary. They won't cause that much damage, but they will be there in the field throughout the year. What is sporadic pest? Here you can see pest which occur in a few isolated localities like coconut slug caterpillar in the South India. Okay, so this is not the full definition. This is based on only occurrence. Again, we'll discuss in the damage potential more clearly about this sporadic pest. Now we will discuss about classification of pest based on infestation, degree of infestation, intensity of infestation. So it can be categorized into two types. What are those? Those are your epidemic and endemic pest. Epidemic and endemic pest. Here you see, you have to remember two term. Okay, you can make a column like this. Okay, this is epidemic, this is endemic. Okay, here you can see two terms are there. Like in epidemic, severe one term. Another term is your time or season, anyway time only, in season specific. But in case of an endemic, occurs regularly, okay, and here that is your location specific. Okay, that means here what will happen, particular to the time, okay, particular to the time, and here it is particular to the locality, particular to the location, okay, severe and regular. Okay, so these are the major difference among this epidemic and endemic. Here you can see the definition. So what is the definition? Epidemic pest occurs in a severe form, okay, in a region or locality, not particular, in a region, at a particular season or time only, is known as what, your epidemic pest. Severely occurring in a particular time, like BPH occurs severely during October and November, that is known as what, your epidemic pest. Anyway, here the term is not there, it should be written what, your severe. Okay, it should be written as your severe. Okay, similarly, if you see in case of endemic pest which occurs regularly, this term is there, and confined to a particular area or locality, in a particular area they are there, okay, that is known as what, your endemic pest. Like rice gall mites in Madurai district, rice time borer in Cauvery Delta, some particular area is given, okay, occurs regularly, that is known as what, your endemic pest. Here you can see this is the BPH, okay, these are the stem borer, this is the larva, okay, this is the adult. Okay, now we will discuss about pest classified based on damage potential. On damage potential, how pests are classified? So here the important things are there, and from this only the short questions also come in the exam. Okay, so what is a key pest or severe pest? Second one is major pest. Third one is minor pest. Fourth one is potential pest, and fifth one is sporadic pest. One by one we will discuss. Now coming to your key pest, otherwise known as severe pest, what is that? These are the most severely damaging pest. The GP always lies above EIL. Here you can see this is the GP, and this GP is always lying above your EIL level. This is known as what, your key pest or severe pest. Human intervention may bring the population temporarily below the EIL, but it rises back rapidly, and repeated interventions may be required to minimize the damage. That means if at this point you are doing intensive, extensive, continuous management, then what may happen, this GP may come below your ETL level and here it will fluctuate. That means what has happened, this GP is modified. So what we can write down this one, MEP, that means modified equilibrium position. If in the real GP of key paste, intensive continuous management techniques will be applied, it may be bring down ETL level, below ETL level, which will be known as what, your modified equilibrium position. But if at this point again you stop management, then what will happen, it will again rise back in this old GP. This is known as what, your key paste. Understood clearly? Or any doubt is there? If your management will be stopped, again that will rise above EIL level, again that will become a key paste GP. Okay? This is one thing. Another thing is what? If some shift in environment will come, suppose some tufan came, some disaster happened, at that time also this GP may be bring back below ETL level. Otherwise, they will be always above EIL level. So here the examples are your cotton bollworm and diamond beckmouth, Plutella gyrostella. Cotton bollworm means three are there, spotted bollworm, American bollworm, pink bollworm, Pycnophora gossypella, so many are there. You can discuss in the paste of crops, paste of cotton. One more thing I forgot to tell you, this is the time x-axis, okay, slipping line, and this is the population density. We have discussed these things while understanding ETL, EIL, GP, yes or no, huh? There we have discussed all of these things. Now coming to your major paste or perennial paste, okay, perennial paste, okay. These are the paste with the population crosses EIL quite frequently. That means you see why the term is like this. They will be always near your ETL level, fluctuating near ETL, and frequently they may cross this EIL level. That is what it is telling. You may be confused, the graph is different and this one is different, right? But what is the meaning? This ETL is always near, sorry, the GP is always near or fluctuating near ETL level, and frequently it may cross your EIL level. Okay, so here what will happen, timely spray, timely management is required to manage that particular paste. Okay, regular management is also here required. Okay, if at this point, that means what is the meaning, if at this point you do the management frequently, timely, then what will happen, it won't increase. If you won't do anything, then it may frequently cross the EIL level. That means you do the management here only, so that it cannot be a major paste. Understood? That is the meaning of this graph. Okay, and here the damage is more than 10%. This only comes in the exam. More than 10% damage occurs in which kind of paste? So that will be your major paste. Okay, 10% damage, cotton jasseed, rice, stem borer. Then coming to your minor paste or occasional paste, these are the paste with population rarely crosses EIL level. Here you can see this GP is very below even your ETL level. Huh? Yes or no? They are very minor, negligible most of the time. And sometimes what will happen, this fluctuate around ETL, that means it will come to ETL level. If at this point you won't do anything, then it may cross your EIL level. Understood? Why it is told that with population rarely crosses EIL, it will fluctuate around ETL, and if you don't do anything at this point, they may rarely cross this EIL level. That is what your minor paste or occasional paste. Okay, but this paste are easily amenable to available control measure infrequently, like sometimes if you do the management only at this point. At this point management is not required, but at this point management is required, which is occasional again. Okay, and even in a single application of the insecticide, that can be maintained below ETL level. And here they cause 5 to 10% of damage. In case of major paste, more than 10%. In case of minor paste, 5 to 10% damage may be there. Then coming to your potential pest, what is a potential pest? This pest normally do not cause any kind of economic damage, that means negligible pest, but any bigger change in the ecosystem may make them to cause economic damage. That means, what is the meaning? Some students are there, those are not reading well, but if cheats will be provided with them, they will do what? Outburst. Yes or no? They will score 100 out of 100. That is what your potential pest, which may not occur in general. Yes or no? That is your what? Potential pest. But some students are also there, even if you give them cheats, they cannot find where is the answer. Those are your what? Negligible pest. Try to understand like this. Okay, what is potential pest and what is negligible pest? Now coming to the last one but not the least, that is your sporadic pest. Very, very important. Here you can see, one by one we will discuss every point. At first, what we have discussed, sporadic pest means in an isolated locality. Yes or no? This one first we have discussed. Remember, okay? Then you see, GEP generally below EIL. You see, GEP is not generally, totally below EIL level. Most of the time in a year, they are below EIL and even ETL level, very close to your damage boundary. Okay? Even below damage boundary also. Okay? The population of this pest is usually negligible. That means below damage boundary level. But in certain years, what will happen? Under favorable environmental condition, they appear in a virtually epidemic form. Here some things are coming. What are those? You see, virtually, okay, then your epidemic. Okay, what is virtually? What is epidemic first? Epidemic means severely in a particular time. So in this graph you can see, here they are negligible, here also they are negligible. But in this particular season of a year, they are becoming a severe pest because they are crossing above EIL level. But is it true? No. What is the meaning? In this time, they are not epidemic. During this time, they are not epidemic. That's why it is known as what? Your virtually epidemic. Understood? This is known as what? Your virtually epidemic. Okay? One thing we have understood, isolated locality, then this EIL below, GEP below your ETL level. Okay, these things also I should write. GEP below, EIL level, near damage boundary or below damage boundary. Okay, third one is virtually. Fourth one is epidemic. They are epidemic in nature. Okay. From form crossing many times over DB and EIL. Definitely. They were under DB, but now they have crossed EIL level. Yes or no? EIL level. Under these conditions, the pest has to be controlled by undertaking suitable management strategies. That means only during this time. Okay. This time you have to do the management practices. Okay, other time they are already below your ETL level, even below damage boundary, so you do not have to consider. But during this particular time, during rainy season, like August to October. Okay, at that time the pest population is more, so when they crosses ETL level, you start the management, continuous management, only during that time. Other time you do not have to bother about that particular insect. These pests are highly sensitive to abiotic conditions, yes or no? In this abiotic condition only they will increase, and if the favorable situation will go, their population is decreasing. Okay, only a residual population survive. If the favorable season is gone, only a residual population will survive. You see, this was like this. When favorable situation came, it became like this, then gradually it decreases. When the favorable situation is going, only a residual population will be left which will be regarded as negligible pest below your damage boundary. For example, white grub, hairy caterpillar, cutworm, grasshopper, they emerge during your rainy season only. Okay, other time they will be negligible. They may be visible in the field, but not having that much of potential. So which points you need to remember? First one is in isolated localities. Second one is GP always below ETL level. It is written as below EIL, but you can write down ETL or DB also. Okay. The population of this pest is usually negligible. You know, yes or no? Here they are negligible. Okay. Here also they are negligible, but here they are more. They appear in a virtually epidemic form. This is a point. Okay. Only during this particular time, virtually epidemic time, you have to do the management. Otherwise, management is not necessary. And if the abiotic factor will be unsuitable for them, they will come back below again damage boundary and becoming a negligible pest. So now you might be having some doubt, what are the difference between this minor pest, major pest, then this sporadic pest and epidemic pest? Yes or no? So here you can see, in case of major pest, what is happening? The GP rarely crosses EIL, but GP is very close to your ETL level. If at this point, if you won't do some regular timely management, it will frequently cross your EIL level, for which at this point only you do the management. This is what your major pest damage is more than 10%. Very, very important, comes in the short question. Then coming to your minor pest, here you can see GP is far below than your ETL level. Rarely, occasionally, it may cross your EIL level. But if you do some very few time, otherwise only one time management at this point, again they may be rise back below this ETL level. Yes or no? This is what your minor pest damage is, 5 to 10% damage may be there. Now coming to your sporadic pest, you see the difference between these two. Okay, what is the difference? Here you see, in this particular time period, it is totally higher. Yes or no? Where? In case of your sporadic pest. But here you see, there is no time specificity. It has increased this time, again it has risen back, came back below ETL level. Again, during some time it has again increased. That means this is occasional and this is seasonal. Understood the difference? Yes or no? Now coming to what is epidemic, what is sporadic and what is seasonal. You see, sporadic combines epidemic and seasonal. That is the utmost concept. Sporadic means it combines epidemic pest which are seasonal. Again, epidemic means severe and seasonal. Yes or no? So this is just a combination. That is the only difference. Okay. Seasonal means occurs in a particular season. Yes or no? Torment condition appeared. Yes. Seasonal. Epidemic means severe, crossing the EIL level. Severe. So both are known as sporadic. Okay. So these are the things. Okay. Here you see, this is the major pest, minor pest, sporadic pest, epidemic pest, seasonal pest. Okay, these are here. Okay, so it may be a confusion, that's why I have discussed separately. So thank you all of you, and if any kind of doubt is there, you can ask. Thank you. Have a nice day.